Hi everyone, let's start TCT AP 2020 live case session 3, Mitral Clip Case. I'm Jungsung Kim from Yonsei University, Severance Hospital, South Korea. It's my honor to moderate this session, and it has been a year since mitral clip procedure was introduced in Korea, and we look forward to expanding more in this year. Now, I would like to introduce a distinguished panelist, Su Shen-shung, KKEO is my great friends, and Doyun Kang and Tae Kim. I hope this session can help you to understand mitral clip procedure. Dr. Kang prepared interesting case with severe MR, especially DMR, and demonstrate mitral clip procedure step by step. Dr. Kang, please.
Thank you for your instruction. And I will share my live case, one case with a severe DMR, and I did it with Dr. Tae Kim, our imaging specialist. Let's share the case. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. I am Dr. Doyun Kang from Asan Medical Center. It's my honor to present the live case of the mitral clip. This is my team, Dr. Ko, Eui Hong, and Mr. No Jin Seok, and our anesthesiologist, Dr. Kim, and our echocardiography specialist, Tae Kim. And Dr. Ko, can you please present the case?
Okay, thank you. The case is 79 years old female who have diagnosed severe eccentric MR 5 years ago, and now she has worsening this year, and the transfer, this fragile echo finding shows a significant prolapse of the medial commissional leaflet of mitral valve, and also she had a recurrent chronic pancreatitis requiring a ERCP and a ERPD for 7 times. And next, her cardiovascular risk factors contains diabetes and hypertension and hyperlipidemia, and the STS score is 3.3. And she also have a paroxysmal atrial fibrillation 1 month ago. And next, EKG showing a sinus rhythm, but she has a paroxysmal atrial fibrillation from 1 month ago. And next, chest x-ray shows a normal, and next. This is a TTE finding, shows a LVEF is 62%, and the LV end systolic diameter is 30 millimeter, and the LV end diastolic diameter is 53 millimeter, and severe MR, and mainly A3 prolapse. So after this clinical presentation, Professor Kim will show the detailed information about the TEE finding. And coronary finding shows a normal coronary angiography. And next.
Yes, the patient is a 79-year-old old woman, and she was suffered from chronic pancreatitis and experienced recurrent admission for 7 times during 3 years, and received many procedures, and she's very frail. And the severe MR was diagnosed 5 years ago, and the symptoms, dyspnea is increasing, and so we decided to perform the mitral clip procedure for this very frail old woman. And Dr. Kim, can you please show us the echo findings for this patient?
Hi, this is Tae Kim from Asan Medical Center. Can you see the echo image? As you can see here, this is a bicommissural view. Where is the pathology? Here is a big prolapse segment. It seems like A3 prolapse. Do you agree the finding? In color flow image, you can see a big picture. And there is something wrong in this image. What is wrong? As compared with big picture, the thickness of vena contractor is not thick, indicating the region jet is not fully visualized in this image. In this case, we have to put the probe much deeper like this. We can clearly see medial commissural prolapse like this and small caudal rupture in this area. In color flow image, as compared with the previous color flow image, we can see much bigger fissure and much thicker vena contractor, indicating fully visualized mitral regurgitation death. the radius of PIJA was 13 millimeter, indicating very severe mitral regurgitation. The pulmonary vein flow in left upper pulmonary vein indicating systolic flow reversal, indicating severe mitral regurgitation. In 3D amphastic view, you can see interesting finding as compared with the A3, P3 prolapse. In patient with medial commissural prolapse, you can see a big coaptation gap further medial side right here. It's different from A3, P3 region. For periprocedural planning, in patient and just only A3, P3 region, just one clip has to be placed right here. However, in patient with medial commissural prolapse, if you first clip in A3, P3 region, as you can see here, the big coaptation gap can be remade. So significant mitral regurgitation can be remained. For this patient, for procedure and planning, especially in patient with medial commissural prolapse, initial clip had to be placed further medially initially. After that, second clip had to be located in A3, P3 region. In a color flow image, you can clearly see a big ligation jet from the medial commissural prolapse. Thank you very much.
Yes, thank you, Dr. Kim. Yes, the patient has severe eccentric mitral regurgitation by the prolapse of the medial segment. And the clipping in the medial segment is a little bit difficult and dangerous because there are so many chordas and structures. And second, because the angle goes through the transseptor and go to the mitral valve, the angle is very stiff. So there's some difficulties in the medial side mitral clipping. So discussion with the echo view and making the treatment plan before the procedure is very important for fluent procedure and good procedure outcome. So we perform the before beginning the procedure, I want to ask the panelists that about the patient selection and the procedural planning. This patient is 79 year old, old patient, and not seen in this video, but very frail patient because of the chronic pancreatitis with a recurrent admission. So we choose the mitral clear approach without surgery, but actually the STS score is only 3.8% or low risk patient. And how about the selection of the patient with this kind of the DMR patient? Not prohibited risk, but clinically high risk, but STS score is not so high. I want to ask the panelists' opinion about the patient selection for mitral clear procedure.
KK?
Very much for sharing this case, Dr. Kang. I think this is an appropriate case in that this is a frail lady and the recurrent bouts of pancreatitis and would have made it difficult for her to recover and have strength. I would also say that the various scoring systems, whether it's STS or Euroscore, don't evaluate frailty very well. And at age 79, I find it, I think it's reasonable if a patient is reluctant to go for surgery that we should offer the less invasive therapy. I guess my only area of concern is that this commissural prolapse is not easy to do. I may have missed it. I lost video for a while, so I did not see the LVOT view. So I was hoping to catch an image of the LVOT view, but certainly the intercommissural view and then the 3D view suggests that this is a very commissural prolapse. So I think steering down there will be difficult, but not impossible. So I'm looking forward to seeing how you do the case. Thank you. Over to you.
Yeah. So one question to Dr. KK. In Singapore, do you usually do heart team approach in this kind of case?
Yes, we do. Most times these cases are referred to me by the surgeons. So it makes it easy because you know, the surgeon would offer the surgery and would quote a high risk because of the frailty. And then the patient will refuse surgery, and then they will refer the patient to me. So the heart team, we do conduct the heart team discussion. I think the main thing is that the biggest question that we have to ask in cases like this is, will the patient be agreeable or not agreeable for bailout surgery? So if something goes wrong, usually for these cases, I really would like to make sure that the surgeon and the patient are both agreeable to proceed with bailout surgery.
Yeah. How about the Dr. Sung in Taiwan?
Yes. Yes. I think we also we put advocacy into the heart team discussion. So also the surgical risk, I agree with KK that although the surgical risk is not really high, but we know that the frailty is not really to be calculated in the surgical risk. So I believe that the surgeon would be the most appropriate person to define whether the patient can undergo the surgery very well and recovery well. So I think it's all about heart discussion. And regarding the case, and also in contrast, the pathologist at the media commission, I know we all agree that the surgical repair for the mitral valve is the best option to conduct to for this patient. But for the commission pathology, I don't think the surgeon, it's really difficult to conduct a very good surgical approach. Although they can do the just to suture ligation similar to the Afari procedure, that they just do the patch on the medial commissure, just like so. What, which is similar to the mitral clip. Also, if you conduct a traditional surgical repair, it's really difficult for the medial commissure or even for every commissure pathology. We see many cases in our hospital that patient with commissure pathology, the with the traditional neoco and annuloplasty, actually the residual MR remains. So, and regarding the mitral clip procedure, because when you do the commissural clipping, the mitral valve area would be safe a lot. So there would be a very little impact on the mitral valve area reduction. But indeed, it's a difficult case. It's a very medial commission. But I have a very first question about, given that Dr. Kong has presented the case might have an atrial prolapse, if I remember the presentation, I don't think this could be a very important because the patient have medial commission pathology. If you, from my point of view, I believe this might be a commission P3. So because when we conduct the mitral clip procedure, the first thing is that we have to identify what the pathology and also the correspondence leaflet to do the grasping. So if this is anterior leaflet, you have to identify the posterior. If this is the posterior P3 commissural prolapse, you have to clip in onto the anterior corresponding area. So from my view, the image tells me that the patient have commissural P3 prolapse. So we have to, the procedure would be very simple. You put the very first clip at the very video side and to make sure that there would not be no residual MR from the medial side. And then you can put another clip if it needed later to the first clip.
Maybe Dr. Tae Kim will give us some more comment because with his echo.
This patient had a medial commissural prolapse, but some patient had, as Dr. Sung mentioned, anterior dominant medial commissural prolapse or posterior dominant medial commissural prolapse. It's very difficult to differentiate the two types of medial commissural prolapse. I think the one most important thing to differentiate between of them as the location of pizza is very important. This patient and anteriorly located the pizza, I think the medial commissural prolapse is anterior dominant prolapse, maybe, I think so, yeah.
Okay, then I will resume my case.
So discussion with the echo view and making the treatment plan before the procedure is very important for fluent procedure and good procedure outcome. So we performed the venous puncture by right femoral vein under general anesthesia. And Dr. Kim is evaluate the TEE. And with the SL1 catheter and broken bone lead, we performed the septal puncture. This is the routine septal puncture procedure under TEE guidance. Dr. Kim, can you please show the TEE image during the septal puncture?
Yeah, this is a final shot after septal puncture. Yeah. This is a medial lesion. We the septal puncture height very close to 4.5 centimeter. We get 4.46 centimeter from the lesion, as you can see here. Yeah.
Yeah.
Just a quick question. Is this a G4 or?
And distance from the cut.
We are not available.
Yeah, this is the NT.
Yeah,
this
NT,
is the order for the NT. Yeah. G4 is okay. Not yet available in Korea, so this is NT version.
Okay, got it.
Is there any difference, stretch between XT and G4? Yeah.
Not so much the difference. I think the NTRs and the G4s, the big difference, I think, is the independent grasping. So I was just curious because if you have the even older version, then the trajectory control is not so good, and there is a tendency for the CDS to go medially. The trajectory is not straight. Whereas I think for the NT system, in the G4 system, the trajectory is straighter. So there are some, pros and cons of each of these devices.
We are all waiting for the J4. It's very important for successful procedure. And about 4 to 4.5 centimeter from the puncture position to mitral annulus is needed. And especially for this patient, the patient eccentric MR is positioned at medial place. So we try to make a higher septal puncture to make a good approach. Actually, in this patient, I did not use any BB needle or the RF needle, and I just pushed a little bit, but the catheter introduced into the LA, and fortunately, the position was very good, so I introduced the steerable guiding catheter. Can you please show the image? This is the steerable guiding catheter with a minus and plus knob. They make the guiding catheter more steerable or straightened. Because the catheter is very thick with the outer diameter 24 French and very stiff, so during the introducing the catheter into the LA, we must be careful about the risk of the IVH rupture or other damage. So I introduced the stiff wire into left superior pulmonary vein, and with the fluoro image, slowly introduce the guide catheter into LA. And now we are here. Yes. Dr. Kim, can you please show the position of the guide catheter?
Oh, okay. This is a live echo image. Eh? Yeah. Can you see the tip of the catheter? Dr. Gang, please withdraw the catheter.
Yes.
1 or 2 centimeters from the original lesion.
Yes, 1 or 2 centimeters out. You mean?
Withdraw.
Yes. If I push back the withdraw, the whole system and the catheter goes to the medial position a little bit out. So you can adjust the mediality or laterality mainly by pushing the all systems in to make a lateral and out to make it medial. And with the, and now I will push in the catheter, the clip to minimize.
Just one question. Yeah.
Yes.
So before introduce the clip system, do you usually check the LA pressure?
Yes, I checked the LA pressure, and this patient, the LA pressure was mean LA pressure was 12. Yeah. We usually check the pressure before introducing the catheter. Yeah. I've heard that with GEM4, the simultaneous LA pressure monitoring is available.
Yeah.
Is it right?
Yeah.
But you know, we haven't found it very useful because depending on the angulation of the guide and the system, Sometimes the guide, when you have, when the angulation is substantial, you do lose the pressure tracing. And we find that even though I think up to 2 years ago, there was a lot of talk about the importance of LA pressure. I do think it's important, but I think it's not well understood because sometimes when you think the MR is severe, the LA pressure is not high. And sometimes when you think when the LA pressure is high and the MR doesn't look too severe, or after you fix the MR, it still doesn't look too, the pressure remains unchanged. So it's hard to make sense of it. For me, the pulmonary venous flow measurements are a lot more useful.
Yeah.
But nonetheless, I think having LA pressure does add another piece of information for complex cases.
Yeah. And actually, before the procedure, we performed the massive volume reduction for a successful procedure, and the LA pressure is usually very low, lower than echo measurement. Yes. Okay. And
I introduce the case. The clip.
Yeah.
This is very basic step.
In the clip, and there is some blue line here to make a good align. I must make the blue lines in one line, and then push in the catheter.
Still slightly deep.
Yes. Okay. Yes, I will a little bit put out the catheter.
Yes. Yes. That's it.
Because there is no fluoroscopic structure in the LA, so the TE guidance is very, very important.
Oh, slightly deep. Yeah.
A little bit still. Okay. Okay. Then I will introduce the clip into the LA. Can you please? Okay, now clip is coming out.
Can you the clip in the echo imaging? Yeah, in the middle of LA, you can clearly see the tip of mitral clip. Yeah.
Okay.
The arrow indicating the tip of mitral clip in echo imaging.
Yeah, so clip is coming out into LA. Can you please show the tip of the clip?
Okay.
Not to touch the LA appendage or the Coumadin ridge is very important for safety.
Yeah, far from the appendage.
Okay, thank you so much. This is the saddle position that the two markers of the clip is the tip of the steerable guiding catheter is at the center of the two marker tip of the clip. At this position, the clip clip angle is very accurate in idealistic position. And then I will make a M dive, then make to use this M knob with a posterior motion.
Okay, let's move to the biplane image.
Yes, thank
from
you.
Now on.
If I make the M, move the M knob, the catheter, clip catheter moves like this. It goes into the mitral annulus. And if I just use the M knob, the catheter goes to the anterior position and can make some touch on the annulus. So I concurrently use the P direction of the catheter. If I rotate the steerable guide catheter in the clockwise position, and the whole catheter goes to the posterior position. With this, and looking.
Okay, it's closer.
Yeah, TEE. Now, the catheter is around the mitral annulus.
Okay, you have to place the clip more medially.
More medially, okay, then I will.
Far medial side is preferred.
Okay, pull out the whole catheter. As the medial position is very difficult. There are so many structures and chordas, and angle is very steep.
But the clip is not visualized in bicommissurable. What's wrong with this?
Okay, let's see. Where is the clip?
Please move the biplane cursor, Dr. Lee. Okay. Oh, yeah, right here. Yeah.
Okay. Now clip is in the very medial side.
Okay, that's it.
I think it's very medial side of the annulus. It's very difficult to visualize good biplane image.
Okay, the clip move toward anteriorly, as you can see, LVOT view.
Okay.
Yeah.
I will move a little bit posteriorly.
Oh, okay.
Is it better? It's at the very medial side to cover the commissural MR.
Oh, that's okay.
Okay. Then let's see the trajectory angle.
Okay, please check the trajectory right here.
Okay.
Please widen the clip slightly into the LA. Too much interact with leaflet right now.
Okay.
Okay.
Is it okay now?
Good place. Slightly anteriorly dived.
Yeah. Because there are so many structures, codas, leaflets.
And medially dived as well right now.
Yeah. Okay. A little bit laterally. Is it okay now? Here.
Not yet. Where is the clip?
Here you can do a very the only shadows.
Oh,
of the
okay,
clip.
Okay, okay, okay. Yeah.
Yes.
Okay.
Okay.
Good,
then
good location.
I will check the trajectory.
Okay.
Go in and out. I think the angle would be good. How do you think, Dr. Kim?
Oh yeah. Okay. I agree.
Yeah. I will open the clip. To 180 degrees.
Jump, please.
Okay. Oh, there are some air. To minimize the risk of the air embolism, to keep the all the line and device without air is very important.
Let's also take the orientation in this view using 3D, real-time 3D.
Yes, can you please give me the 3D en face view? And also we are checking the ACT every 20 minutes to keep the ACT in the 250 and 350. Yes, now the ACT is 330, very good.
Considering the location of a far medial side, you have to slightly rotate counterclockwise.
Okay.
From the view.
We will tackle the valve with a little bit angulated.
Okay.
Shape to give appropriately clip the lateral, the medial side. Okay. Oh no. The clip is a little bit inside to the LV.
Okay, for medial region, how about close the clip a little?
Okay.
Yeah. The chance of cauda entrainment high in this area, as you know.
And go through into the LV. Do you like this angle?
Oh, okay. Yeah. Good position.
Okay,
right
then.
Here.
To minimize the coda tinglation,
good.
So I inserted the clip with 120 degree and we'll pull out slowly to check whether.
Okay, good.
And let's check.
Grip is down.
Yeah. Can you see that the posterior fluid is not fully covered, but I think that the posterior fluid on the right image is not in the same plane. How do you think? Cervix. Are you a little bit closed?
Okay.
How about the?
Oh yeah.
Posterior fluid was not fully.
Can I make a quick comment?
Yeah.
Check the color.
So I think first of all I want to say that the imaging is really very nice here. The clip arms are really well seen. As I look at this procedure, the first thing I would say is that when you drop the grippers, it might be worthwhile to see unless it's very difficult to grasp the leaflets, to see the grippers bounce with each heartbeat in terms of being lifted away from the clip. And I think that will give you a lot of reassurance about adequate leaflet capture. And I think especially when you are very commissural, The interaction with the walls of the ventricle can sometimes, you know, shift your position away from where you would like it to be. So, but I think you have, you know, from what I'm seeing, you have made a good attempt to grasp. I guess your next few, the next segment of the video will show whether you actually grasp the defense. I just thought that it's good to see. If you can see the grippers bounce up and down, it'd be great.
Okay.
Over to you.
Maybe here, there's some grippers up and down.
A clip is a little bit inside to the LV.
Okay, for medial lesion, how about close the clip? Yeah, yeah. The chance of cord entrainment high in this area, as you know.
And go through into the LV. Do you like this angle?
Oh, okay. Yeah, yeah. Good position.
Okay, right then here. To minimize the coda tingulation, so I inserted the clip with 120 degree and will pull out slowly to check whether.
Okay, good.
And let's check.
Here it is a little bit of moment.
Gripper is down.
Yeah. Can you see that the posterior fluid is not fully covered? But I think that the posterior fluid on the right image is not in the same plane. How do you think? Sherwix, are you a little bit closed?
Okay.
How about that?
Oh, yeah.
Posterior fluid was not fully
covered yet. Yeah, but I checked the color.
Yes, okay.
Oh, much improved the MR. Yes.
I just closed to 60 degree.
Uh-huh. Oh. There is a hope of using just one clip in this patient.
Because there are so many structures in the media.
Just full coach the clip.
Yeah, so I want to minimize the grasping and releasing the clip.
The posterior captured sufficiently, I think.
Oh, very good.
Okay, very good, yeah.
Then I will minimize the tension a little bit.
Oh, better than expected.
How about the TEE result, Dr. Kim?
Oh, yeah. Please minimize the tension, please.
Okay.
Yeah.
I will push a little bit.
In this case, this case, after deploy the clip, usually the degree of MR increase. You have to consider that.
Yes, that's right. Because we are just catching with the tension, the mitral valve. So after releasing the clip, the tension becomes a little bit different.
As you can see, the medial region, for medial side, Dr. Lee, please indicate the using arrow pointer. Can you see porous remaining porous segment in the far medial region? But initially I locate the clip more medial side, but our clip location is more lateral than expected. This is an incidental finding. I think that the result is very good.
To create the very medial commissural portion is very very difficult and a little bit dangerous.
Dr. Gang, I think the capture of a posterior reflex is not sufficient.
Yeah.
After, how about retrying the capturing of the posterior reflex more sufficiently?
Okay. Then, as you can see in the echocardiography, the posterior reflex, there is a little bit of prolapse remained, and Dr. Kim wants to move the whole system more medially a little bit. So I will try it again. I'll push out the clipper.
If the location is good.
Yes.
Then
I will unlock
just,
the clip.
At this site, you have to try capture poster leaflet more aggressively.
Okay,
yeah.
Then I will open the clip into 100 and
in this site. Yeah, yeah,
20
yeah.
degree.
Slightly move toward the posterior, poster leaflet more than before.
Yeah, posteriorly by rotating the guide catheter a little
okay,
bit
but
clockwisely.
Yeah, for now the anterior leaflet is problem. Too much move toward posterior
okay.
leaflet. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
To make a balance.
Yeah,
very difficult.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
With the XTR or more longer version, it would be easier then.
Oh, now it's good.
Now
it's good.
Is it
yeah,
good?
Yeah.
Okay. Then move.
Okay.
Move a little bit. Then I will catch.
More upper side, please.
More
upper side of posterior plate. Yeah,
okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Try in more upper side. Okay, better than before. Please, by plane.
What do you think about this?
Okay, better than before, I think.
Yes, I want to go more, but I cannot because there is some angle and medial side is
okay,
too close from the septal puncture position.
Oh.
So
much better than before.
Yeah.
Slightly trivial with just one clip.
Okay, I just closed 60 degree.
Full close, please.
Full close. Okay, I will close fully and we'll minimize the tension.
Yeah, please minimize the tension.
Okay.
I think we can end the procedure of just one clip.
Oh, much better than
before,
previous.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, let's check the color flow in multiple image.
Yeah.
Color, please.
Now is the imaging specialist time. Yeah.
Actually, I mean to jump in here, I like to
it's based on like. Imaging
yeah.
and the hemodynamic.
Yeah. Hi.
Yeah.
I was going to say that I think the decision not to accept the first grass is a good one, because if we are not sure about the capture of any of the leaflets, and in this case the posterior leaflet, it would be really unwise to release because you know then. If you did capture the posterior leaflet, it looked like it was only the tip, and there's a good chance of single leaflet attachment. So
yeah.
I think being fastidious as Dr. Kang and Dr. Kim were is really a good demonstration of excellent decision making.
Actually, during the second attempt, I pulled out whole system as much as possible, but still there was some short. Still the catheter was inside the valve. So I pulled out full system a little bit. So that worked.
There's one other technique you can get to
yeah.
make it go more medial, and that is a breath hold. When you suspend respiration or ventilation,
yeah.
it will shift the catheter more medially. And sometimes when your other maneuvers don't work, the ventilatory breath hold can help you shift your catheter more medially.
Okay.
So KK usually use some respiratory maneuver during the procedure, especially in medial side, or
yeah, if it's if there's a commissural disease, I sort of test and see how much impact the ventilatory breath hold has on shifting the device, because sometimes when you're already in the LV and you try to move it medial lateral, no matter what you do, it doesn't move much. And you end up distorting the anatomy because your guide is now pushed too much in or too much out. So I found that the ventilatory breath holds do help. However, most of the time it is sort of an expiration and you might have to use to have your anesthetist use a bag to if you need to do a full inspiratory hold. But most times, if you have a expiratory breath hold, it will shift the thing immediately. But it's worthwhile to rehearse it with your anesthesiologist to see which way it goes if you're not sure.
Yeah, that's a very good tip.
Mm-hmm. I also think that the data can also express a very good technique to do the commercial clipping, that you advance the clip just merely beyond the liver tip, and then you pull back the clip and try to grasp the liver at the very first beginning, immediately after when you dive into the LV, and then you pull back the clip and try to grab the liver. I think it's a very nice technique. If you dive too much because the commercial, just the quota issue, you probably will get quota entanglement. So Dr. Khan today provide a very good technique to do the commercial clipping. And also the image, the Dr. Kim also demonstrate a very good image that Dr. Khan can follow the image and to finish the whole procedure at very quick, just I believe in minutes, even in seconds. So that's a very nice work.
Yeah, thank you so much. Yeah, and let's see Dr. Kim's echo.
Yeah, excellent result.
And we must think about the risk of the mitral stenosis after the clip insertion. But the patient had a mitral valve area was 4.5 or sufficiently large, and with just one
clip. I think the result is very excellent with just one clip.
Oh, yeah. Very
good. You can see AR jet in this view, and this is not MR.
Oh, yes, AR jet, it is.
Okay, let's check the pressure gradient right here.
Yes. What is the appropriate pressure gradient?
It's usually less than 5 millimercury.
Mean?
Yeah, mean pressure
value.
Gradient. Yeah,
okay.
Okay, let's try to measure.
With a CW image tracing, he is
measuring mean pressure gradient transmitral, just 2 millimercury. Good.
Okay.
Let's check the upper pulmonary vein flow, liver cell. Okay.
The risk of the MS is very low because the
In this view, we have checked pulmonary vein flow in left upper pulmonary vein. Completely disappeared liver cell of left upper pulmonary vein.
Yeah, good result.
Mm. Yeah, excellent result. Let's check the 3D image from now on. Okay, right here. Okay.
That's beautiful 3D image.
Let's check a different image.
Yeah.
I'm not happy with the 3D image right now.
That's so beautiful it is.
Okay.
Okay.
Dr. Kim is very strict for his image.
Two more hands.
And you can see that Dr. Kim is now wearing his radio protective glove in his left hand.
The interference with a catheter, the 3D is not good right now. But after removal of catheter, I show the better 3D image.
Okay, there is the catheter in front of the clip.
Oh, okay, but good. Clip location, I think.
How about the amount of the mitral regurgitation?
Trivial.
Very good. But it can be changed after releasing clip.
I agree.
Because the tension and anatomy changes.
Let's check the elbow view once more. Okay. Zoom, please. Oh, okay. Good coaptation. Both anterior and posterior, I think. The chance of embolization is too low. Okay?
Yeah. What's your criteria to evaluate the risk of the embolization?
But good to maintain good coaptation length is very important. I think
sufficient coaptation
length. I think that the position is good, the stability of clip and sufficient coaptation of both anterior and posteriorly. I agree. The deployed clip right now.
Okay.
Yeah. Everybody agree?
Yeah, I agree.
yeah, fully agree. Yeah. Your opinion.
Then I will deploy the clip. It's okay?
Okay, yeah.
Then release. To check the final arm angle. And now it is okay, very stable. Okay. Then I will check the grip line. This is the grip line. A more thinner line. And there is some letter grip parts. And remove all rubber. And check the grip line move where? In two directions. Now it's okay. Then I will remove the clip lever tip and remove all rubber tabs. Okay. Let's check why the line moves well in two directions. And check the final arm angle. Now it's very stable. Then I will remove the long line. The long line must be removed slowly because air can be introduced with the long line. And it's very smooth. Okay, now it's okay. Then check the arm angle again. Now it's okay. Then remove the safety pin. And counterclockwise rotation till there's a marker at the tip of the device. And rotate the actuator knob 8 times counterclockwise. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now, this is the moment. I will remove the clip. Okay. It was removed very smoothly. I like it. And then I will remove the grip line very smoothly. Because there is some tension between the clip and the device tip. So not to make a damage. Looking at the floor, and we remove the grip line very, very slowly, gently, with the beating of the heart. Okay. I make a little bit. Okay, now it's much better. The grip line is removed. Dr. Kim, can you please evaluate the final result
okay.
after first clip?
Usually after deployment, degree of MR increase. However, in this patient, slightly increased the degree of MR. However, in trivial degree, excellent result.
Great result.
Yeah, let's check the stability of clip.
Yes.
Once again, Dr. Lee, please. Move to biplane image in from commissioner view.
Yeah, I will remove the first clip device.
Please, zoom please.
Okay. Because there is some possibility of the second clip to minimize the air introduction into the device is very important. Okay.
Okay. Okay, I think the in this view, the stability of clip is good. Ah, okay. Oh, very excellent feature.
Yeah.
With just one clip.
Could you record the pressure gradient, please?
Yes, I will check the pressure gradient after clipping. before clipping, the mean average LA pressure was 15 millimeter mercury. Now let's check. Oh, it's very low. Can you please show the, oh yes, you can see the graph. The mean LA pressure is about 9 now. Yeah.
Yeah, there is a very low amplitude of the B wave.
Yeah. Removing the very fantastic result. It will become much lower.
Yeah.
Yes, let's check the final result. Can you please show us the final echo result that came?
Can you see the live real-time live 3D image?
Yes, oh, very beautiful.
Yeah, you can see a beautiful clip location over there. No visualization of quantization as previously mentioned before. Okay. Yeah. Okay, please. After then, color, please. Oh, trivial.
Trivial MR.
Yeah, trivial Behind. MR from.
Great news.
Okay, please. Okay, excellent result. Yeah.
Okay, then I will remove the catheter and can you please check the iatrogenic ASD?
Mm-hmm, okay.
Okay, now I removed.
Okay, color, please.
Device into LA. RA.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
Yeah. Can you see iatrogenic ASD in this view? Okay.
Okay.
Let's check the complication after the procedure. Every function is good. No pericardial effusion. Yeah, okay. No evidence of a complication right now.
Okay. Then I will wrap up the procedure. The 79-year-old female with frailty and many concurrent comorbidity and with a severe eccentric MR with the prolapse of the medial segment. And we performed the mitral clip procedure for degenerative MR. And with the one clip, you can see the final result with a trivial MR remained. I'm very happy with this result. Yeah. And thank you for my colleague and Dr. Kim.
Thank you.
Yeah, thank you so much.
Yeah, congratulations, you're a great result, very short time. How long did you take this for this procedure?
Actually, this video isn't that edited. This is a real-time video.
Oh.
So with introducing the clip to finish was about 30 minutes. And this is a very happy case.
Yeah, it's a very nice result.
Yeah. Thank you so much.
Congrats for this fantastic case. I just have a very simple question. Also, you conduct a very impressive procedure using the anti-system. I just wonder, given that, is STR available in Korea now?
Oh, it's not available yet. It will be available this year.
Yes, if you have XTR, would you consider to use the STR to do the commercial clipping?
Yeah.
We know that would be also another challenge to avoid coda entanglement. But if you have very lengthy prolapse, if that would be very helpful. I just, what would you, if you have next case, when would you consider to conduct the NT system, to use the NTR system or use a longer clip?
I hope so.
I was going to say that for the XTR, I've not used it a lot. Mainly because you know, if you had to use it, it is usually with a lot of concern about rotational deformation of the valve, because the moment you're just a little bit off with perpendicularity, you can deform the valve. And as you pointed out, Adam, with the if you are very commissural, the risk of caudal entanglement and hitting the walls of the ventricle is really substantial. So by and large, I haven't had to use many XTRs. I have used them in the tricuspid, but in the mitral, haven't had to use too much of it. Most of my cases are either NTs or NTRs or NTWs currently. So So I would say that the XT systems are used with a lot of, you know, when I use it, I'm always a bit paranoid. So just, it's just my fear of bad things happening.
So in this case, I think there is some possibility or difficulty to be entangled when we introduce the ventricular side. So is there any some recommendation or caution to avoid that kinds of problem?
Yeah, I think the Dr. Kam has already demonstrated a very good technique to do the commissural prolapsing. He just advanced the correct the orientation in LA, and then he advanced the clip into left ventricle by fully monitored by the TEE image. So that Dr. Kim also provide a very good TEE image. So when Dr. Kam advanced the clip just beyond the tip of left leg, and he pulled back the clip and tried to grabs the lip at the very first beginning. And I believe that is the best technique to do the commissural collapse. And also, I think the Dr. Kim is a very strict TEE image provider because, yes, he saw the medial side there remain a very small prolapse at the medial side. And he remind the Dr. Kim to move the clip much medially. So that's the teamwork to finish this fantastic case. Yeah. Congratulations, this case is, fantastic.
Yeah, I think that those points are really excellent. And the other thing that I've seen people do is if you were going very commissural is to go in with the clip arms closed or 60 degrees because you don't want the clip arms to touch the walls of the cardiac structures and, sort of push it out of the way. So some people in the commissures would go in with the clip arms closed. That's something, but I think the key is actually as Adam described, which is to not to go too far in and to monitor it closely on both echo and to a slightly lesser degree on fluoro. I guess the advantage of looking at fluoro is that you get a sense of whether the device has spun as it goes down. So I think it's good to keep an eye on both, which I think in this case was very well demonstrated. So again, a wonderful result. Congratulations.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, I agree with KK. I have mentioned that because I also have some experience using the ST system to treat the commissural prolapse because it's a very lengthy leaflet. So when we introduce the clip into the LV, I will close the clip. So just similar as Dr. Khan has to do, he closed the clip a little bit and then advanced to the left ventricle. And when you just get beyond the clip, you slightly open the clip and then continues to pull back. Just avoid open the clip and admit the ventricle. That is the key, the tricks to avoid caudal entanglement. So maybe you just need to close clip, dive into that ventricle and try to correct your orientation before you open the clip again. So that is what we will concern during the commercial clip.
Yeah, thank you for your very nice comments. Yeah, to avoid tangle in this somewhat very retro or medial part of the mitral regurgitation. So now scheduled time is up and we will wrap up today's session. Thank you for Dr. Kang and Dr. Kim to present very interesting, very educational case and Dr. Song and Gyo productive discussion. Thank you so much for watching our session at TCTAP 2020 virtual, and I look forward to seeing you face-to-face after COVID-19 in the near future. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Bye-bye. Thank you. Bye-bye.